Yes, my modifier sheet, Dodge Charger, Hellcat type spoiler. I'm going to fit this on my Dodge Charger 2016 SXT model. As you can see here, this comes in a pre-prepped or a pre-painted finish. You can see this is matte black. What you can do is you can paint this in the color of the body that you have, or you can go ahead and have it painted in choice of any color that's funky or a contrast. What you get here is you get a mounting hardware. You can see here you get a foam tape. It's not a double-sided 3M tape. It's just a basic foam tape that you can stick on the spoiler. This also comes with guides that are used to drill holes on the boot. In a while, I will flip the spoiler and show how it goes. You also get 3 bolts used for mounting. So here's the other side. You see the mounting surface. You see 3 holes that are used for mounting the spoiler. So this guide basically sits in the hole. You need to fit all 3 of this, flip it over on your boot and place it in a proper position and fix these guides, and then take out the spoiler, and then what you can do is start drilling on the boot. But what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to drill. I'm going to show you one easy way using 3M tape and silicone adhesive. I'm not too comfortable drilling my boot, and there would be many like me who are not willing to kind of drill the boot. So this would be really good for them. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to paint this in Plastidip Luxury Sapphire black that will have a metallic gloss to it, followed by a nice glossifier. So before mounting, I'm going to do this. I'm going to mask this surface and give it a nice plastic dip. So that's it. I'll show you the painting process in a while, so stay tuned. So let's begin cleaning and prepping the spoiler for painting. What I'm doing is, I'm taking a microfiber cloth and a 50% isopropyl alcohol solution and just wiping it along. Further, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take a brake cleaner spray and give it a nice clean, but do not directly spray it onto the spoiler. Use the damp cloth which is there, just spray a little bit, and using the same damp cloth, give it a nice clean again. This will ensure all the dirt, grime, greasy substance, wax is all gone. Now the surface is clean and ready to be masked. So what I'm going to do is, the surface which is going to be mounted, where I'm going to apply the 3M tape and later the sealant, I'm going to mask it so that the paint does not go onto it. So let's begin the masking process. masking is now complete. What I've done is, I'll show you the edges. You can use a knife to cut them sharp, neat and clean. Now, this spoiler is ready for painting, so stay tuned. I'll begin with the painting process now. So before painting, what I've done is I've just placed the spoiler on my boot and I'm just checking what all the areas I need to cover perfectly. The ones which are visible, they need a good amount of paint. So as you can see, this is the top surface and the slant surface is pretty much visible from the rear. So we need to cover them really good. So those are the areas of focus. So I went ahead and bought two plastic dip cans, matte black from Walmart. They're pretty cheap out there, just around $6. And I have ordered this luxury metal plastic dip, black sapphire. This has a metallic shade to it. I bought it from awarehouseful.com. They're pretty cheap, $48 for the set. It comes with four plastic dip luxury metal cans and two glossifier along with a can gun. Their service is pretty good. It is cheaper than dipyourcar.com. This is the can gun. It becomes very easy to spray with this instead of painting your fingers pressing the nozzle. And this is a glossifier. This has a UV protection to it. So if I don't like the matte finish, I'm going to spray a glossifier over it to get a nice gloss finish. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a small tub. I'm going to place all these cans inside and pour in some warm or hot water and leave it for 10 minutes. This helps in atomizing the spray better. You should not spray when the can is cold. So one thing you guys need to make sure is the cans should not be totally immersed into the water. The water should not get into the caps, else it's going to be a problem. This is exactly what I wanted to avoid. This particular can flipped and the water went inside the cap up to the nozzle. Luckily it didn't cause any damage. So what now I have done is I have placed a weight over the cans so that they don't float. Now I'm going to wait for 10 to 15 minutes, let the cans warm up and begin with the painting process. I have placed the spoiler on two stools. I put some Jenga blocks beneath it so that all the edges that I need to paint are visible. I've wrapped the stools with a plastic sheet so that I don't overspray them. So we kept this 10 minutes in the warm water. It's ready to spray now. The climate is good. It's not too cold. It's around 68 Fahrenheit. You should make sure it's not too windy, else it's a problem to spray. If you don't have a garage, you can do it outside. For example, I do not have a closed garage, so I have to do it outside in my patio. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give this can a nice shake. And what we are going to do is we are going to just clamp this. So what you need to do is give this, hold this nice tight and just press it forward. It's a little bit tight, but it should be easy. So as you see, it's done, nice to grip. So let's begin with our tack coat. You can start with the edge which is visible.
This should be a light coat. You do not want to cover the entire top with a light coat. I'm going to let it dry for 5 minutes and then we will follow this up with our weight coats. So I'll come back in like 5 minutes and start spraying again. Alright, I see that the tack coat has dried. Now I'm going to start wet overlapping coats. What you need to do is basically spray this way. This way it's easy and you make 50% or 60% overlap and spray it nice and wet. The first wet coat is done. I'm going to let it dry for 15 minutes. Then we are going to do one more coat of this, and then we are going to start spraying the Plastidip luxury metal that has metallic gloss into it. So we'll let this dry for 15 minutes. So the first coat is done. What I'm going to do is in a similar fashion. I'm going to do a horizontal with a 50% overlap. All right, now the matte Plastidip has dried up. Now we are going to start with our final coats of luxury metal. I have mounted the spray gun on this. Okay. So this is going to be wet coat and not the tack coats like we did earlier. So we are going to start with the edges and then we are going to spray it on the top. Nice wet coat. So I'll start. Give it a nice little shake. So here's the problem. You see this nozzle? It's not meant for this gun. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull off the nozzle from the earlier can. I'm going to put it on this. I'll come back after I do that. So I've changed the nozzle as said. So this is the dip spray nozzle. This is the one which you can use with the can gun. The earlier nozzle is totally useless. The spray pattern on this nozzle is also way better than the earlier ones. So let's begin spraying the wet coat. So it's time to switch to glossifier. So what I've done is again I've put in the tip spray nozzle onto my glossifier can, and you need to make sure when you're spraying the glossifier it should be a deep, wet, slow coat, because if you spray lightly then it's again going to be textured and the gloss won't come out and it will really look again like a clear matte finish, which we don't want. If you want a real gloss, you should go very steady, smooth, and have a better coverage. So let's begin. You can see the finish as it's drying. You can see the shine and gloss at the same time. The shine is from the metallic particles in the Plastidip luxury metal. So let's see how it looks on the vehicle once I mount it. You need to allow like 8 hours to dry completely, to settle in before you install it on your car. But pretty much I'll do this maybe tomorrow. See you then. So as you can see here, what I've done is I've put a 3M tape throughout. I've also masked the holes. So what I'm going to do is I've also marked the center of the spoiler using this hole. Now what we are going to do here is we are going to mount this without drilling. So I'm going to use a silicone adhesive that I bought from Walmart. I'm going to put it in a zigzag pattern throughout, and then we are going to place it here. Once the silicone adhesive is dry, it's going to grip the spoiler to the boot, and let's see how it goes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some isopropyl alcohol, 50%. So I'm going to clean the surface. Just dab it onto your cloth and just clean the surface. Oh, here's the silicone adhesive that I was talking about. This is the Permatex black adhesive sealant. This can be used as a gasket marker too. So I'm going to use this. It comes with a nozzle. You can cut the nozzle in the size that you like. So I'm just screwing this. Okay, I think we need to puncture this first. Just puncture this. I just put the nozzle. And we need a little thick layer. It should not exceed the 3M tape and go out. You have to make sure it stays within this region. So I'm just going to use the knife and cut it here. So this will be thick enough to spread. This should be enough. I think this is enough. I'll just wash my hand. I'll be back. Before peeling off the backing layer, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this butane torch and heat it a bit because it's pretty cold outside. So quickly just heat it. Do not heat it too much. Just a little bit. The torch is very powerful. See, what I've done is I've peeled off the tape. Now let's heat it once more